Good morning. This is the last two stanzas of the poem Table Turn. Okay, in this stanza, in the last second one from the last, sweet is the lore which nature brings, our meddling intellect besets the beauteous forms of things. We mutter to dissect enough of science and heart, close up those barren leaves, come forth and bring with you a heart that watches and receives, that watches and receives. Okay, this one, sweet is the lore which nature brings. Here, difficult words in this stanza is lore. Lore means traditional values and cultural values. Lore means what is the traditional values and the cultural and cultural values of country, or a place, or in a small village, a small sector, smaller sector. Okay, and next one, meddling. Meddling means mixed knowledge. Meddling means what is that? Mixed knowledge. Book is knowledge, is mixed knowledge. Okay, we can read number of books written by number of people so that we gain knowledge. That is a mixed knowledge. Mixed knowledge. These are the difficult. And dissect means analyze. Dissect means analyze by thinking. Analyze, what is that? I analyze the things point by point. Point by point. Or analyze by thinking point by point. Point by point. These are the difficult words in this stanza. Now listen. Sweet is the lore which nature brings. The other greatness of the nature is nature carries our traditional values and cultural values from one generation to another generation. Is it clear? We know our traditions, we know our culture because of the nature. After we death, our grandsons or our children may know the culture because of what is that nature, because nature carries these values, carries what is the traditional values and cultural values to the next generation. Is it clear? So this is the greatness of what is that nature. The sweetness of nature is to carry our values, not only in our what is that only Indian or in a small what is that India or any other country. So the people where live in a small area, the nature surrounding them carries their values to next generation. Is it clear? So that is, and our meddling intellect misses the beauteous forms of things. Our mixed knowledge. Mixed knowledge, intelligence, nothing but knowledge. With our mixed knowledge, we misshape the beauteous forms of things. Beauteous forms of things. Okay. So actually, present modern human beings are looking at things for purpose only. Without purpose, we never look at what are the things. We never go into the nature. We never do anything. We did anything with a purpose. So that here our present poet said, so modern human beings misshape the beautiful things in the nature. They don't like the beauty. They don't enjoy the beauty. They don't admire the beauty of nature, because their mind is filled with what is that commercial. Their mind become commercial. They're thinking commercial. They want to fill their wallet, but they don't want what is that look at the beautiful things. Is it clear? They don't have enough time to go into the nature to enjoy the nature. enjoy the nature because they get enjoyment, but their enjoyment will not fill their what is that wallets, or they will fill their what is their pockets, or their lockers, or their lockers. So that modern human beings with their intellect, what kind of intellect? Mixed with intellect, we save the beautiful, beauteous forms of things. Beauteous forms of things. They are giving a misshape. They are giving what is that misshape. They are not look at the beautiful things in a right way, you know, with a right point of view. They are thinking about them with a useful, with another purpose, with a another purpose. Is it clear what I am saying? This is. So వాళ్ళు ఎప్పుడైనా సరే వాళ్ళు ఏమంటుంటే ఉపయోగిస్తారంటే ఏదైనా ఒక వస్తువు చూసినప్పుడు దానివల్ల ఏం ఉపయోగపడుతుందని చెప్పి ఆలోచిస్తారు తప్పించి అది అందంగా ఉంది, అది చాలా అట్రాక్టివ్ ఉంది, అది వల్ల ఏంటారు దాన్ని చూడటం వల్ల మనకు ఆనందం కలుగుతుందని చెప్పి ఆలోచన మాకు ఉండదు ఎవరికి ప్రజెంట్ మోడర్న్ ఫామ్ మీన్స్ ఇస్ ఇట్ క్లియర్ సో విత్ దేర్ మెడ్లింగ్ నథింగ్ బట్ మిక్స్డ్ నాలెడ్జ్ దే ఆర్ లుకింగ్ at the what is the beauteous forms of nature with a other what is that with a purpose but the nature will not have a what is that purpose is it clear so this is we murder to desert with our meddling intellect we don't have analyzing power we have a analyzing power what is that to fill our purse only, to fill our wallet, but don't enjoy the nature. In this process we murder to desert the beauteous forms of things, this is the first stanza. This is the meaning of this stanza. The meaning of this stanza is what is that so the sweetness of nature carries our values from generation to generation. With our meddling intellect, we are misshaping the beautiful forms of things. We don't know its value. We don't have enough time to enjoy the future because our mind is filled with commercial things. We are thinking commercially. So when we are thinking commercially, what will happen? Indirectly, we murder to we never analyze the things. We never analyze the beautiful things in the nature and the useful things of nature. This is the meaning of this stanza. Now come to the last stanza. It is the heart of the poem. What is the heart of the poem? The last stanza is the heart of the poem. Okay, this is a good one. Enough of science, of art. Close up those barren leaves. Come forth and bring with you a heart that watches and receives. At last, what is that? William Wordsworth is asking his friend, enough of science. Oh my dear friend, stop reading the philosophy of science and the philosophies of what is that arts. Okay, leave the books of science, the books of arts. Okay, and he said, what is that? Close up those barren leaves. So according to William Wordsworth, the books of arts are what is a barren leaves. They are a barren leaves. According to is that William Wordsworth, barren means not fertile. Barren means what is that? Not fertile or withered. Withered means dry and useless. According to William Wordsworth, the philosophies of science are the books on science and the books on arts are useless. Are useless. So that he give a call to who is that? His friend, his beloved friend, close up those barren leaves. Close up the books of science and close up what is that? The books of arts. Because they are useless. Okay? The knowledge gained from the nature is far better than what is that? The knowledge gained from sciences and arts. That is the reason why he said what is that the books of science, the books of arts are barren leaves, useless, or withered and dry leaves. So he give a call to his friend, come forth, come into the nature, and bring with your heart. Bring with you a heart. What kind of heart? A heart that watches and receives. That watches and receives. So William Wordsworth is asking his friend, "Oh my dear friend, come into the nature. Come into the nature. When you come into the nature, don't forget to bring a what is that a heart. You come into the nature with a heart. With a heart. What kind of a heart? A heart that watches and what is that receives. A heart that watches and receives the beautiful things of nature, and what is that the message of nature, the good message of nature. Is it clear? Okay. So you come. If you come, you should bring a heart. A heart should watches the beautiful scenery of nature, the beauty of nature, and the heart should enjoy what is the nature. And another one, a heart should receives the great message from the nature. A heart should learn many things from the nature. So you should come with that kind of heart only. With that kind of heart only. If you don't have that kind of heart, don't come into the nature. Don't come into the nature. This is the call and this is the message given to who is that? His friend, his beloved friend. So why should he come? Why should he say you should come with a heart? Every man should have a heart. Should have a heart. But he is saying you should have a what is that? You should come with a heart which what is that? Which watches and receives. Which watches and receives. So some people are coming to the nature or coming what is that? Going to do something without heart. Nothing but they never focus on the things. With a negative mind, they are coming and they are doing something. So the result is not good. The result is not good. So that he is specifying, you should come with what is that heart, which watches and which receives what is the beautiful things from the nature. Beautiful things from the nature. And why I want to say one more thing, difference between mind and heart. Mind, what is that? Mind can analyze the beautiful things. Is it clear? Well, mind can know what is the right and what is the wrong. But here heart can understand what is the beautiful message, the beautiful message. This is the difference between mind and heart. Mind and heart. So that is the reason why at last he is giving a call to his friend. Don't forget to bring it. A heart that watches and receives. That watches and receives. Is it clear? So this is the poem Table Turned. So the main theme of Table Turned is leave the books aside. Is not saying leave all the books. Okay, you can spend some time on books, but we have to focus on what is that nature. You have to spend so much in the nature. When you spend so much time in the nature, what will happen? You have a knowledge as well as a good health. As well as a good health. If you spend so much time on reading books in a closed room, what will happen? You have a knowledge. That knowledge is not enough. That knowledge is a mixed knowledge. Because what is that? Those books are written by some, what is that? Only human beings. They don't have a relation with what is that nature. That is the reason why William Wordsworth saying stop reading the books which gives you what is that mixed knowledge which makes you double or which lost your identity. Is it clear what I am saying? So that is the reason why he said what is it? Come into the nature. Nature is ready to give you so much knowledge. The knowledge is true. And nature gives you a true wisdom. Nature gives you true wisdom. And wisdom and knowledge have what is that? Universal acceptance. But the knowledge is gained from the books is what is that? Doesn't have universal acceptance. Oka book nu sambandhinchina knowledge anadi, దానికి యూనివర్సల్ యాక్సెప్టెన్స్ ఉండదు యూనివర్సల్ అది రైట్ కాకపోవచ్చు ఓకే బట్ ద నాలెడ్జ్ గెయిన్ ఫ్రమ్ ది నేచర్ దట్ హ్యాస్ యూనివర్సల్ యాక్సెప్టెన్స్ వేర్ ఎవర్ యూ గో దట్ ఈస్ రైట్ వేర్ ఎవర్ యూ గో దట్ ఈస్ రైట్ ఓకే సో దిస్ ఈస్ ద మెయిన్ మెసేజ్ ఆఫ్ ది పోయెమ్ సో స్పెండ్ సో మచ్ టైమ్ ఇన్ ద నేచర్ learns many things from the nature and you have a strong what is a body strong mind and good health strong mind and good health so thank you very much